everyone, my name is Ebony Robinson and I work in career development services.
Hi everyone, my name is Casey Shaum and I also work in career development services.
So today in this video, we're going to talk to you a little about tips and strategies when you're looking for a job.
So first off, we want to make sure that you are spending enough time on the job and internship search and application process. Make it part of your weekly routine. Put it on your agenda, your calendar, in your phone, however you keep track of your assignments and time. You want to add in blocks of time that you're dedicating to the career and internship search. You also want to stay organized. We tend to apply for multiple positions at once we're in the internship or job search. So you want to use something like an Excel sheet or a notebook to handwrite everything down that you need to remember. The job you're applying for, at what company, who are you addressing the cover letter to, what is the website, what are their values, what is their mission, why are you applying for this, and when is it due? You always want to start with the ones that are due first so you don't miss a deadline. You want to use a professional email account. Your ODU one is fine, but you can also create a professional email address that you use for the job search. You want to make sure that you're checking it regularly so you don't miss that communication from an employer. You also want to set up your voicemail. We've heard from employers that they've called students to talk to them about setting up an interview and they didn't have their voicemail set up. We tend to not answer phone calls from people we don't know and we don't call it back. So you want to make sure you set up your voicemail and make that professional as well. Finally, you want to make sure you're researching the companies. I mentioned the mission and values. That's going to really help you in the future know if you want to apply and work at this company, whether it's for an internship or a full-time job. You want to know if you're going to enjoy your time there. What is the culture? What are they looking for? What are the qualifications that they're seeking? What skills do they want you to have to be successful? So make sure you're doing your research in advance so that when it's time to write your cover letter and resume, which Ebony's going to tell you about, you're ready.
Definitely. So when you're doing your resume, a few things you want to be mindful of are, first of all, your grammar and your spelling. Make sure you're checking these things. The first way that employers kind of weed out candidates is by looking at the spelling and grammar in their resume. Are they reiterating bullet points? So are you taking the same bullet point and just saying in a different way in a different place? Avoid doing that. Make sure that your resume is concise and to the point of the job description. Your job description is my next tip. It's so critical for you to review the job description in relation to your resume. When an employer is looking at your resume, they know what they need. So you telling them all about all the things that you've done is great, but they may or may not care. They really want to focus on, can you do the job based on the job description? So reviewing the job description, particularly the expected experiences or the required proficiencies or the preferred proficiencies, are going to be the first thing that employers are going to look for. So that should be the first thing that you're looking at when you're developing your job description inside your resume. So the different things that you've done. The next thing you want to do is make sure that you're focusing on your achievements and accomplishments as opposed to your duties. Typically, we can kind of figure out what a waitress did or what a researcher has done or different things like that. What made you stand out in comparison to your other colleagues? Make sure that you're focusing on your achievements as opposed to your duties. When you're focusing on your achievements, make sure you're quantifying as much as possible. Did you raise a certain amount of money in a very specific period of time? So instead of saying I raised $10,000, instead of saying I raised money for an organization, you may say I raised $1,000 within a 3-month time frame for my student organization, or I managed a budget for my student org or for my job or wherever of $800. And using those numbers will make you stand out in comparison to some others that may apply. The next thing you want to do is make sure that you are not using a template, and that's for your cover letter or your resume. I've been on a number of search committees and I may have to review anywhere between 20 to 100 resumes. And so in that job, while I'm reviewing those resumes, I may start to blend templates together, and I'm not alone. Other job resume reviewers, other hiring managers are doing the same thing. You don't want to blend into the background. You want to stand out. So making sure that your resume has a format that allows you to stand out without being overbearing is wise. So avoiding templates is the best the best way to do that, making sure that you stand out in a group. You also, when you're writing your cover letter and your resume, be sure that if you mention an organization in the resume and cover letter, it's the right organization that you're applying to. I've seen people apply to jobs, and because they're, you know, we've all done it. We've been in a major job search and we apply to a bunch of different places. Well, make sure you change the name of the organization in that cover letter and that resume, because you don't want to email the biology department or ADP with Geico's name on it. So you want to make sure that you're using the correct organization in your resume and cover letter. But that goes back to your grammar, your spelling, and just in general editing your resume.
The next thing we want to talk about is the significance of networking and also mentorship. Mm-hmm. Take advantage of the campus events where you're able to network with your professors, your peers that are in your classes, the employers that visit campus, whether it's at a career fair or they're hosting a table in our web center. Stop and talk and ask questions. This is a great informal way to start networking with other people. And if you have the opportunity, attend a conference. Those are a great way for you to meet people outside of ODU and the Norfolk community. Definitely. Also, finding a mentor is so important. I personally have the same mentor since I was a freshman in college, and she has seen me through grad school and through all of my first years in the profession. And she still is the number one person I reach out to because she knows me, she knows my strengths, she also knows what I need to work on, and she'll be really honest with me. So make sure you find that person who's going to be honest with you.
Definitely. The last thing I want to encourage you all to do is, as you're in this, even as a freshman, start to follow us in Career Development Services on our social media platforms. So you can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, or Pinterest. These are great ways to find out, one, what we're doing, two, how to interact and engage with employers that you may or may be interested in, and some that you may not even know that you're interested in yet. So definitely connect with us and follow us there. You can also always email us or do a virtual drop-in for us. We're here to support you and get you to whatever career success looks like for you. So thank you so much for your time and watching this video. If you have any other questions, just reach out and let us know, okay? Ebony Robinson here.
Casey Shum.
Bye, and we'll talk to you soon.